guys, so I thought I would come and do my intro because I filmed one, but I was talking really quiet so you couldn't really hear. But I thought I'd come update you guys and do an intro to the vlog. So welcome to the last Vlogtober. I am at my mom's house now, and let's see. Monday I finished reading Mexican Gothic. I ended up giving it only 3 out of 5 stars. I didn't think it was, I don't know, I didn't think the action was that great. It was very atmospheric, but overall I just thought it was all right. I really liked the ending, but yeah, I just gave it 3 out of 5 stars. So I did finish this Monday, and then we also watched Coraline on Monday, and then yesterday, and then I also did an unboxing for you guys. I got some book mail, so I'll go ahead and put that in here. Got 2 packages from Book Depository, which I ordered a while ago. So let's go ahead and open them. My battery's flashing, so I'm gonna hurry. So first we have The Secret History by Donna Tartt. Oh, this is a nice floppy one. Really pretty. Oh, I like this. Yes, so after reading These Violent Delights, I already knew that I loved Dark Academia, but after reading that, I was like, I need more. This is the Dark Academia everyone talks about, and I haven't read it yet. And I really like this edition, so got that one. One more. Oh, pretty. Oh, I love this spine. Okay, so I got Daddy by Emma Klein, which is a collection of stories. She wrote this book called The Girls a while ago, which I absolutely loved. I loved her writing. So I said anything she ever comes out with ever again, I'm gonna buy it and read it. And I love the UK edition, so I got it off Book Depository. And I'm super excited about this. I just love this cover. No idea what it's about. Don't ask me. No idea, but so pretty. So these are the 2 books I got from Book Depository. Hey guys, so we are at the used bookstore. It's like 11:40, just got here. I'm super excited. Julian came with me. He's also vlogging. I'm excited, Junior, you're excited?
Nope.
Yay! And I thought I would show you guys the books that I got. I didn't go as crazy as I normally do, but I did find some good ones. So I found this really pretty cloth-bound edition of Dracula, which is weird because I specifically have been wanting this to match my picture of Dorian Gray. So I was super happy to find this again at a really good price. Beautiful. Love it. I picked up The New Wilderness by Diane Cook. I just heard about this because it was, I think it's shortlisted now for the Man Booker, and it was one of the few that I actually wanted to read off the list. So I was happy to find that. And then the last one I found was Ninth House by Leigh Bardugo. I do already own this, and I've obviously read it, but I loved it. But I wanted this hardcover edition because the one I currently have is Book of the Month edition. And I know that when the next book comes out, I'm gonna want it in like the regular hardcover, not Book of the Month edition. So got it so it can match. And I really love the shiny snake, and it's another Dark Academia, and I love this book. I know it gets a lot of hate, but I really liked it. Those are the books that I picked up from the used bookstore.
11 o'clock and I've just been up doing nothing. But yesterday you guys saw I started The Seven Deaths of Evelyn Hardcastle. I didn't get too far, I only got like 35 pages in. Yeah, but I'm really, really liking it a lot. It's very fast paced and easy to read. So I'm definitely gonna try to read more of this because I'm really, really liking it. So that's gonna be the plan today. Nothing really is happening. I'm gonna try to read at least like 100 pages of this. I think that's the plan. Now like almost 2:30 and I've almost crossed the 100 page mark of The Seven Deaths of Evelyn Hardcastle and I am loving it. It is so good, so interesting. Don't know what's happening. You guys know I love books where you have no idea what's going on. You have to figure it out. The author is not giving you any clues. I love it so much and we've already woken up in a couple different bodies, so it's just so interesting. I'm loving it and it actually is very creepy and eerie, so it's like perfect for this time of year. Yeah, I'm loving it so much, but I think I'm gonna take a break now. All right, so we're playing Among Us. I've never played before. Playing with my brother.
Oh, great.
And my other brother on the phone. Oh, almost. Okay, we're about to start.
Walking on fire, trying not to bend my feet. I'm tired of fighting, saying things we don't mean. You know I don't like it when you're packing your bag and turning your back, calling me a liar, calling me a liar. Trying not to let my fear.
Alright, so just got done playing Among Us with my brothers. And it's fun. It's fun with like playing with them. I wouldn't play just by myself. I'm looking rough. But yeah, it's like 9 o'clock now. And I think I'm just going to relax. I did read over 100 pages of The Seven Deaths of Evelyn Hardcastle. Like I told you guys, I'm really, really loving it. It's very interesting. Yeah, and I told you guys I was going to a cabin, but those plans got canceled, so I'm not going anymore. So I'm just gonna be spending the week here, which will still be fine with my family. Oh, those cookies you guys saw, my mom made these, like, I think they're called cream cheese. I'll have to ask her. They're like cream cheese. They're really good. I had one, but yeah, that's what she made. But yeah, that's about it. That's the update. All right, so it is Thursday morning and I was just doing some schoolwork stuff, getting some things together for interviews that I got in. But now the sun is actually shining. It's been so gloomy here. I've been wanting to take some Instagram pictures of a couple of books and I got this really cute little pumpkin from Publix that I want to put in the picture. So I'm going to do that real quick and then definitely going to sit down and read some more of The Seven Deaths of Evelyn Hardcastle. Alright, you guys, it's like 2 o'clock, I think.
What time is it?
Oh no, it's only 1 o'clock and I'm out running some errands now. I just have to like go to Ulta, TJ Maxx. My hair looks terrible. I really need to wash my hair. But I did read 50 pages of The Seven Deaths of Evelyn Hardcastle and I'm loving it just as much. It is just weird and keep waking up in different bodies. Every time you fall asleep, he wakes up in a new body, or you can go back into a past body. There's like all these rules and it really reminds me of like if Christopher Nolan were to write a book, it'd be like this. It's like that, where it's just, he comes up with this idea and then just runs with it. And he, you know, has all these rules in his head and you just kind of gotta
figure it out. It literally feels like a Christopher Nolan movie, but less action. But yeah, I'm loving it so far. And yeah, I have no idea where it's gonna go or how it's gonna end. But now I'm at TJ Maxx, so we have to get some more coffee. And then I have to stop by Ulta, I think it's over here. And then yeah, that's the plan.
All right, so I'm back now and I got the coffee. But for some reason I thought an Ulta was over there and it's not. So I'm gonna see if I can get 2-day shipping for the face cream stuff. but if not, I'll just have to buy it somewhere else. Or when I go into the city tomorrow, I don't get it. But now I'm going to make some apple cider and sit outside on the porch because it's so lovely out. Well, the seats are too wet, so I can't sit out there. And I don't know where the other seats are, so I'm gonna have to stay inside to read.
Sounds really sketchy, but I have to get them done for the, I don't know, the hospital I'm doing my next rotation at starting Monday. They want your fingerprints. I don't know why, but there we go. So I have to go do that and I have to like mail it. So yeah, I have to go like all the way into the city. So it's like a 30-minute drive, but okay, garbage truck in front of me. I got my Starbucks, just a blonde roast. I don't get fancy drinks at Starbucks, rarely, very rarely, just because I don't like sweet drinks. Most of the drinks there are super sweet. I just like my plain old black coffee. Anyone else? And it's so pretty. All the trees are like this fall here, which is so nice because where I was doing my last rotation, it was still warm. It didn't feel like fall, and here it feels like fall. It's so nice. It's kind of chilly. Oh, I love it. It's so pretty. But anyways, so I was updating you guys. I started reading Sheets, which is the graphic novel, and it's really cute. It's like one of those cute sad stories, and I'm really liking the art style. And then I did read like 100 pages of The Seven Deaths of Evelyn Hardcastle. So today I'm definitely gonna read more, probably finish the graphic novel today. And I realized that I've never told you guys the plot of either book, so I'll definitely do that when I get home. And then I think later today, Julian and I are going to carve some pumpkins. Should be fun. Hopefully we'll do it. Now on my drive, I'm going to listen to Ariana's new album. She dropped her new album today called Positions, which I do like that song. But I'm excited to listen to this album. I've been needing some new music because I feel like the only new music we've gotten is Taylor Swift dropped her album, Folklore, which I do like. But that's not an album that I'll just like throw on to listen to like jam out to. It is a really good road trip album, but I need some like poppin' music, so I'm hoping Ariana will do that for me. How you be spending your time, huh? How you be using your time, huh? You be so worried about mine, huh? Can't even get yourself mine.
I'm back now, and I did my first listen through of the Ariana Grande's new album. Definitely got better as I listened through because the first few songs I was not liking. But the ones that I like is called, let's see, they're Off the Table, 630, Safety Net, and I like POV, and obviously Positions. But yeah, it's a pretty good album. It's not too bad. But around noon, Julie and I are gonna go get our pumpkins so we can start carving. So I had to think of something to carve because I don't know yet what I want to do. But while I'm waiting for that, I'm gonna try to finish
So like I told you guys, you're following this girl in this small town, and she runs a laundromat with her dad, and her mom recently died, and then you're also following this little ghost named Wendell, and Wendell somehow gets swept into the human world, and I think they're gonna interact somehow. I'm not sure yet, but I really like the art style. Like, oh. So we have that. So I'm gonna read a little bit of this. By Brenna Thumler, and I only give it 3 out of 5 stars. I liked it. I thought it was really cute. It was like a cute little summer read. Cute little fall read. It like wrapped up too nicely, and it was very predictable, and I feel like we could have had more character development, and the plot went through really quickly. I don't know. It's like needed a little bit more. I know it's just a graphic novel, but I don't know. It's like could have gone a little bit deeper, but I think it's still a really cute little story. The sun is shining now and the seats are dry, so I'm gonna go sit outside and read a bit more of The Seven Deaths of Evelyn Hardcastle. I never told you guys what it's about. So this takes place in like old England, old Victorian England. I'm not sure the exact time frame, but basically the Hardcastles own this giant manor, and they invite all these people to a masquerade ball in order to celebrate that their daughter Evelyn is coming back to live with them, because she used to live in Paris. So they have this big masquerade ball, but you find out that Evelyn is going to be murdered. The character that you're following wakes up in different bodies and is trying to solve the murder, and they have I don't want to give away too much, because it's kind of fun to figure out all the little details and all the little rules that the author came up with. But yeah, basically he keeps waking up in different bodies and is trying to figure out who killed Evelyn. But every time he wakes up, he still has memories from the other people. So it's really interesting, really creative, and I'm loving it. Chat, but I'm not wearing it. We're about to go carve our pumpkins. Julian's Bane. He has a mask that he puts on. And I'm a witch, obviously. Can't see everything with my white socks.
But we are initiated, aren't we, Bruce?
Take a bookstagram picture. So we're walking around, trying to find a place. This is my costume. This would be a good thumbnail picture. Now we're going to watch Nightmare Before Christmas. Wait, it's not in focus. Watch Nightmare Before Christmas! This is what we were giving out to the trick-or-treaters. There were only like 6 of them. Anything to say?
Always push yourself harder and harder with exercise.
guys, it is the end of the vlog and the end of Vlogtober. I had a lot of fun vlogging basically every day. I did skip some days, but every day with you guys, sharing all my reading and all my adventures. I hope you guys enjoyed this Vlogtober. I had a lot of fun doing it, but I thought I would come and also wrap up the books that I read this week. So, first thing is that I finished Mexican Gothic by Silvia Marina Garcia this week, and I gave this 3 out of 5 stars. Like I told you guys in the beginning, I thought it was atmospheric and gothic, but it was just like all right, just a solid 3 out of 5 star read. And then I read and completed Sheets by Brenna Thumler, graphic novel, and I also just gave this 3 out of 5 stars. It was a cute little story, but not very memorable. And then I read almost like halfway, page 241 of The Seven Deaths of Evelyn Hardcastle by Stuart Turton, and I'm loving this still. I'm really hoping to finish this within the next couple of days, because it's definitely one of those books, even though it's giant, you want to try to read this like relatively quickly so that you can remember all the little details and all the little rules and stuff. But yeah, I'm really, really loving this. This is excellent. Definitely, unless something crazy happens, I definitely feel like it's going to be a 5-star read, which it was one of my 5-star predictions as well. So really loving that. So yeah guys, these are all the books that I got to this week, and I'm in my new location for my next rotation that I'm doing for the next 2 weeks. That's why the whole background is different. I hope you guys had a great Halloween and a good October. Let me know how your reading went for the month of October, and I will catch you guys in my next one. Bye.